A subset of an array is a possible combination of its elements, and in this video, we will see three ways to generate all the possible subsets of an array. It's called the power set. A subset doesn't need to contain a particular element from the array. So for example, we will have subsets that contain the first element and subsets that don't. And same thing for the second element, we will have subsets that contain the second element and ones that don't, and so on for each element. And to cover all the possibilities at each element of R, we recursively call the function twice, once by taking the element and once by not taking it. You'll better understand with this example. We have the array 1, 2, 3, 4, and we want to generate all its subsets. We are at the first element, we can either take it or leave it. Let's see the case where we take it. You can see that we inserted it in the subset that we're building. Now second element, we start by taking it. Third element, same thing, and last element, same thing. Now I became equal to the length of R, it means that we finished building our subset, we add it to our array of subsets, and we backtrack. We go back to the call that called this one. Now we've seen the case where we take the last element, so we call the function again, but by not taking it. We reach the base case, so we finished building a new subset, we add it, and we backtrack. Now we've seen both cases, so the job of this call is done, we backtrack. Now we've seen what happens when we take 3, so we call again but by not taking it. Here we call by taking 4, base case, we call by not taking 4, base case, we backtrack, and we also backtrack because we've seen both cases. I think that you got the idea, so I'll just let the animation continue the work. But ask me in comments if you didn't get it. You can see that we got all the subsets, we got 16 because an array of n elements has 2 power n subsets, and 2 power 4 is 16. For the code of this solution, our recursive function takes 4 parameters, the array, the index of the actual element, the subset we're building, and the array of subsets. We said that the base case is when I reaches the length of R, so if I is equal to length of R, we append the subset we build to the array of subsets. Else, we call the function twice, once by adding R of I to the subset, and once by not adding it. We always call with I plus 1 to move to the next element. And in the non-recursive function, the one that takes the array as parameter only, we create an array of subsets, we create an array where we're gonna build the subset, we call the function by starting from the index 0, and we return the subsets. This one was the recursive solution, but we will see two other ones. We can think of the subsets of an array of n elements as the binary numbers that can be made with n bits. Let me show you an example. We have our array of 4 elements, so let's generate the binary numbers that can be made with 4 bits. We have 0000, 0001, 0010, 0011, and so on. And as you may know, with n bits, we can make 2 power n binary numbers. They represent all the possible combinations of 1s and 0s. And we can use them to generate subsets of R by taking the elements where the bit is 1, and not taking the elements where the bit is 0. For example, 0000 means that we don't take any element, we get the empty subset. 0001 means that we take the fourth element only. 0010 means that we take the third element only. 0011 means that we take the third and the fourth element, and so on for remaining binary numbers. And binary numbers of n bits are numbers from 0 to 2 power n exclusive converted to binary. So the process applied to each number is to convert it to binary, then generate the subset by taking the elements at positions where the bit is 1. Next number, convert to binary, generate subset. Next number, convert to binary, generate subset. Next number, convert to binary, generate subset. And so on. In code, we traverse the numbers from 0 to 2 power n exclusive, and for each number, we convert it to binary, we remove the 0b part that comes by default in Python by taking the part that starts from the index 2, and we fill unused bits with 0 to fill the size n by using the zfill method. Now we create our subset by taking elements at index g only when the bit at index g is equal to 1, and we add it to our subsets. After the loop, we will have generated all the 2 power n subsets, we return. Third solution now. Okay, let's suppose that we generated the subsets of elements 1, 2, 3. What can we do to generate the subsets of elements 1, 2, 3, 4? We can't just clone them, but we add 4 to the new ones, because the subsets of n elements are the subsets of n-1 elements, plus the subsets of n-1 elements, but with the nth element at the end this time. So the idea of this last solution is that we start with the empty subset, then for each element, we reinsert all the subsets we actually have, but with the actual element at the end. With the array 1, 2, 3, 4, we start with the empty subset, and now with the first element, we clone all the subsets, but by adding 1 at the end. Here we have the empty subset only, and we added 1 to it. Second element, 2. We clone the subsets, but by adding 2 at the end. Third element, 3, we clone the subsets, but by adding 3 at the end. And last element, 4, we clone the subsets by adding 4 at the end. And we got all the subsets of the array 1, 2, 3, 4. In code, the subset array initially contains the empty subset only, then for each element in R, we traverse the subsets we already made, and for each one of them, we add the actual element to it, and we add it to the array of subsets. After the loop, we return the subsets. Little recap of the three solutions we've seen now. The first one is a recursive solution that calls itself twice at each element, once by taking it, and once by leaving it. The second solution works with binary numbers. It generates binary numbers, and each one of them represents one subset that we generate by taking elements where the bit is 1. And the third solution is based on the fact that the subsets of n elements are the subsets of n-1 elements plus the subsets of n-1 elements, but with the nth element at the end this time. Note that the algorithms we've seen now allow duplicate subsets, and that we can use them to generate the subsequences of a string. And obviously, what we did here is reinventing the wheel. We did it to learn more about algorithms, but if you really need to generate the subset of an array, there exist some ready solutions. For example, in Python, you can use the PowerSet method of the MoreIterTrues module, or if you don't want to add a dependency just for that, you can use the combinations method of the IterTrues module and chain the combinations of all possible lengths. We reached the end of this video, I hope that you enjoyed it, like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.